गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सॉल्व क्वेश्चन नंबर 6, 7 and 8 ऑफ एक्सरसाइज 8.2। होप यू हैव अंडरस्टूड द क्वेश्चंस व्हिच वी हैव सॉल्व्ड टिल नाउ। क्वेश्चन नंबर 6 सेज कन्वर्ट गिवन परसेंट्स टू डेसिमल फ्रैक्शंस एंड ऑल्सो फ्रैक्शंस इन सिंपलेस्ट फॉर्म। दे हैव गिवन अस परसेंटेज फॉर्म, we have to convert it in the fraction form and decimal form, and which I have already discussed it in introductory lecture. So let us start. First is 25%. To convert this into fraction form, what we will write? 25%, we can write it as 25 divided by 100 and remove the sign. And you know 25 ones are is 25 and 25 fours are is 100. So your new fraction number is 1 by 4. Now converting 25% into decimal form. Again we will write 25 divided by 100. 25% as 25 divided by 100. And if you take 100 up, so it will become 0.25. Hope you all know how to convert it into decimal form. While you take up, it will move two decimal points because it is two zeros, so it will go two decimal points to the left side. So 1 and 2, 0.25. Next part is 150%. 150% to convert it into fraction form, I will write 150 divided by 100. 0, 0 will cancel out. 5 3s are and 5 2s are. So the fraction is 150% in fraction is 3 by 2. Moving to decimal portion, 150% I can write it as 150 divided by 100. 0, 0 will cancel out. Now 15 divided by 10, this is 1 0, so it will go one decimal place to the left side. So our decimal number will be 1.5. You can also write 1.50, it is okay. 20% in decimal form, to convert it into decimal form, I will write 20 divided by 100, then cut 0, 0, 2 1s and 2 5s. So our fraction number is 1 by 5. To convert it into decimal form, 20 divided by 100, 0, 0 will cancel out, so it will become 0.2. Also you can write 0.20 on the right side. Whatever number of 0 you will write, it is okay. So it is 0.2 or 0.20. Now 5%, to convert 5%, I will write 5 divided by 100, 5 ones and 5 20s will be 100. So our fraction number is 1 by 20. Converting it into decimal form, I will write 5 divided by 100, taking the decimal points up, removing this 100 from down, it will become 0.05. Hope you have understood this question. If not, please go through the introductory lecture first so that you can understand properly. Now question number 7 is very easy. It says in a city, 30% are females, 40% are males, and the remaining are children. What percent are children? There is a city in which 30% are male, 40% are male, sorry, 30% are females, 40% are males, and the remaining is the children. We know out of 100, 30% are female and 40% are male, so remaining will be out of 100 minus 30 minus 40 is equal to 30%, right? 100 minus 70 is equal to 30%. So this is our answer. Therefore children percent is equal to 30 percent. Now let me write question number 8 first, then I will explain. So question number 8 says, out of 15,000 voters in a constituency, 60% voted. Find the percentage of voters who did not vote. Also, can you find now how many actually did not vote? So what the question says? It says that in a constituency. What is constituency? For example, we have the Bhavnagar constituency. In that, some people are there. Some population are there. Here they have given 15,000 voters are there. In Bhavnagar also, we have the number of population. Likewise, they have 15,000 voters. Out of them, 60% of them voted. And we are supposed to find the percentage of voters who did not vote. So let me first write down. I will write number of voters. What they have given us, I will write number of voters is equal to 15,000. Percentage of voters who voted is equal to 60% they have given. Therefore, can I say that percentage of voters who did not vote is equal to, there were 100% people minus 60% of them voted, so therefore the remaining will be the percentage of voters who did not vote, so it is 40%. So percentage of voters who did not vote is equal to 40%. This is our question number 1 till here. Now next question says, can you now find how many actually did not vote? The percentage we know, the percentage of the voters who did not vote we know, and total number of voters also we know. So we will write, therefore, the number of voters who did not vote is equal to how many? 40% of what? 40% of total population. So what is total population? 40 divided by 100, off will become multiply, and total population is 15,000. We will keep here 15,000. We will cut two zeros. 15 for za is 60 and two zeros. So 6,000 people are there who did not actually vote. So we will write, therefore, the people who did not vote is 6,000. Hope you have understood these 3 questions. If not, please go through it and then go through it 2-3 times so that you can understand properly. We will meet with new questions in new lecture. Till then, take care of yourself. Stay home, stay safe. Bye-bye.